Today's topic is the move to the mechanism to the actuator, and the next week is the sensors. Yes, from actuator to sensor is this flow. Yes. So the thing I have to mention here is this additional course is moved from the first announcement is on the Christmas day, but it is moved to the Saturday, okay? Saturday morning. As I told in the email service of the Wasserland portal, it's okay. All the students can attend here. Okay. So it moved because of some requests by some students who wants to go traveling or something in the Christmas holidays. Okay? Yes. So let's go back to the today's class. It is an actuator, and it is mainly about the electric motors, but firstly I will explain about some three kinds of main actuator in the industrial robots. Yes, what is actuator? As I defined several weeks ago, the actuator is a transducer from energy to into some mechanical movement. From energy source, energy is translated into some movement or some speed or some torque and for in some time. Sometimes it's a torque and force or something. Yes. And actuator for robot, it should be lightweight, compact, high output power. Torque weight ratio is very, very important. Yes. I haven't explained last week. As I said previously, the robot is basically link joint, and some mechanism. And some end effector is here and at the end, and doing some tasks like the picking up, assembling, or painting, spraying, or something, grinding, or something. Okay, link joint mechanism. And in some cases of the manipulator industrial robots, yes. Maybe in this configuration you will estimate. Yes, this is a rotation joint. Here is a rotation joint. Here is a rotation joint, and here is a rotation joint. Maybe here is a rotation joint. So the if it is a rotation joint, we can put some motor along this rotation joint here. Then we can drive each joint easily, maybe. You will estimate. But transmission mechanism, I have explained. Yes, last week's example. What is last week's example? Last week's example is in some picture I have explained. Yes, like some here, and this is one first joint. And the link is here, and the second joint is here, and the second link is here, shaft link is here. Yes, and you can image that this motor is put on here, and the motor is put on here. Okay, but as I shown last week, in some robot, The sharp one motor is yes also along here, but it is located here. Sharp one motor is here, and the sharp two motor is also located here. Located here, and the some transmission mechanism is here, and this is a pulley, belt pulley mechanism here, and it drives this by reduction gear. Not motor is put on here. The sharp one motor is here, and sharp two motor is here. Okay. What it means? It means the last week's slide. What is last week's slide? これ先週、これ3か3じゃない3じゃなくて4だ4のあこれですね、これの話ですよ、こっち、これの話ですよ。 This figure is this OK? この、yes first joint is here first joint is hereAnd some link is here, and second joint is here, second joint is here, and the second link is here. Okay, this robot, Scala type robot, is here. And you will estimate that the motor is directly put on here. But in many cases, in some cases, second motor is not here.But this basement, it is located. Some motor is inside this basement. Why this motor is not put on here, but here? どうして? Why?
Easy to maintenance.
That's an idea. Yes. Maintain in some, yes, only this part we have to take care.Yes, next student. What is your idea? Why this second motor is not on here, but here?
Sometimes, for the sharp two, the space is not enough.
Okay, 何 space? Space.
Space management, yeah.
この space, location space is not enough. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's one idea.はい、シューさん。What is your idea? Why sharp two motor is not here, but here? コントロール。ヒート。あ、これなんかここに end effector treat some dangerous material or something dangerous condition so the motor should be far from the end as much as possible is one yes it's always なんか environmental condition ね or some task condition yes this is one idea はい、フェンサーWhat is your idea?
I think that we could use a bearer chance to check the first and second.
What?
Use a bearer chance.
You use a transmission bevel gear?
Gear?
Bevel gear?
Yes.
ベベルギア is not necessary here, but only the frame plate gear can be used. And also, yes, this is a rotation, this is single rotation, this is single rotation. So the
Not necessarily pedagogy, maybe.
Oh yeah, it's okay. Yes. So, next one. Yes, your idea. What is your idea?
You indeed.
What? Part one need more power. Yes. Ah, yes. Now, what is yes? You should explain more. Yes. What?
You may need too small.
Why sharp one is need more power?
Heavy.
Ah yes, motor is heavy, so the heavy weight is put on here, makes the load for the part one motor. Yes, this is the first priority answer. Okay, first answer is yes, some weight should be not the far. This is a basement, so the some weight should not be located at the far from the basement. It should be put near to the basement as much as possible to make, because yes, the in this serial connection, serially connected condition, this motor weight makes a load for this motor. Okay, these two motors makes the load for this joint. These three motors makes more weight and load for the this joint. So the high weight makes a load for the basement joint. Therefore, the motor or something should be put near the basement as much as possible. Yes, not only weight. Weight affect to the torque, of course. Directly torque, but also not the weight, but also inertia is also important factor. Yes, you know that this is a rotational condition. Some weight is put on here, it makes a inertia, R inertia って MR 事情だっけ？だよね、違ったっけ？だよね。だから、if it is put on the here, put on here, I become smaller. Okay. The inertia is also important. Yes. This weight is directly affected to the torque. Static condition, but the inertia makes the large effect to the dynamic condition. Okay, dynamic movement, the inertia makes the large effect, much effect. So the inertia also should be reduced as much as possible. So the some weight should be located near the basement as much as possible. Yes.
Only this is a front cover. So, これ何が言いたかったか? First I want to say here. 何を言うと思って? あ、これだ! Lightweight. Robot motor must be lightweight.As much as possible. Torque weight ratio is important. Yes, if it produces the same torque, the motor's weight
should be smaller and lightweight as much as possible. Okay. Quick response, quick reaction capability, torque inertia ratio. So the inertia is important for the dynamic response, dynamic operation. And controllability, stability, frequency response. Frequency response って何ですか? What is frequency response?
一番後ろの人。
なんだっけ? ヤンさんだっけ? Yes.フリーケンシーレスポンスって何パッチえフリーケンシー周波数周波数フリーケンシーレスポンスこれは私がいつも話フリーケンシーレスポンスがいとるいつもやっているのは これを差し棒を使うんですけど using this this pointing device yes this is the same weight this is a pointing device and usually using like this yes this is the frequency the good response and but if it is loops like this, that it moves like this. And this is a, yes, but to the, yes, in this case, the weight is here, the center of gravity is moved here, and the inertia is larger. So the, yes, it's not good response. Inertia is larger, and also the frequency response is not good in this case.So the frequency response. So how much frequency it follows? Yes. The in for example the 1 Hz it yes. 1 Hz it follows the input output is okay. But more higher frequency it moves it the endpoint cannot follow the input. Okay. So the.Frequency response is also yes. Maybe you know such as a chart, such as a chart like this. なんかさ、frequency がこうあって、なんかこうさ、例えば high hertz. This is a high hertz. Low hertz.、Mm-hmm. It is looks like this. In some cases, yes. Low hertz it can follow enough, but high hertz.High frequency, it doesn't follow. Okay, you may some of you knows about the control engineering, control theory or something. Frequency response is also important part. And also reliability, conservativeness. Yes, next part is a classification of actuators.And electric motor, electric actuator, and hydraulic, pneumatic, and others. Yes, in this class, the electric, hydraulic, pneumatic is treated, and others is mainly treated in the engineering, bioengineering classes. Yes. So this is the electric motor, and the hydraulic motor, and the pneumatic motor. This is a comparison.Of these three main actuators used in the industrial robots. Electric motor is maybe you are commonly used and very well known. And hydraulic is mainly the oil pressure, and pneumatic is driven by mainly by air pressure. Okay? Yes? I'm going to show this video firstly the hydraulic.Hydraulic short video. Only short video.
Hi guys, and welcome back to HomeVisualWorks.com and TechTricks.info. Today let's learn how a basic hydraulic circuit works with the help of this animation. We'll animate all the components.
まあ、これがオイルソースで、オイルソースで、で、なんかこれシリンダーね。で、オイルソース、プッシュ this cylinder, so it moves. It moves.
Component and see how it works. Different cases, FMRV and other activities of a basic hydraulic circuit will be explained. Just watch the video and learn it. So let's identify the components. That's the hydraulic tank over there. That's a hydraulic oil stored inside the hydraulic tank. Then we have the hydraulic hose, which connects to different components. That's a hydraulic pump, and that's a main relief valve over there. You can see the manually actuated valve block lever there. That's a valve block, so the valve block and the internal gantries of the valve block. Then we have the hydraulic ram, or it's kind of called as an actuator. Then comes the filter, the return actuator, and also the strainer inside the hydraulic tank. So now let's see case one, how it exactly works. Case one is neutral circuit. You can see the internal gantries of the valve block is changing to neutral circuit. In neutral circuit, no work is happening. No, it goes through the strainer, sucked by the hydraulic pump,
and
goes to the main relief valve,
go
and
back
neutral
to
circuit
here.
Gets to the rotor line, and gets filtered and gets back to the hydraulic tank. So that's what's happening in the neutral circuit. No work is happening. And let's see the case two. In case two, we activate the lever. So that the gantries of the valve block changes to service activation mode. So service is getting activated. So now let's see how it works. The oil gets through the strainer, gets filtered, and the pump sucks the oil. It passes through the main relief valve, and you can see the path of the oil. It gets into the head side of the hydraulic ram. It pressurizes the piston on the top, so the piston moves down due to the pressure. And through the rod side, the oil escapes to the return line and gets filtered and gets back to the hydraulic tank back. So that's service activation mode. Now let's see overloading. When overloading happens,
overloading.
So the oil is getting into the hydraulic ram. You can see here overloading happens. You can see overloading is happening and the pressure comes back. Pressure comes back, and if you see there is no main relief valve. The pressure will directly hit the hydraulic pump,
not
here,
go
and damage
to the core.
So now let's see how the main relief valve protects the hydraulic pump. So here we have the main relief valve. So this condition only happens, the hydraulic pump damage, when the main relief valve doesn't function. So here we have a main relief valve. What it does is, it is set at 200 bar pressure setting. So
when
pressure
one direction variable
200 bar happens, the main relief valve acts and reroutes the oil into the rotor line. So it does not allow the oil to go towards the hydraulic pump to damage it. It reroutes the oil, gets filtered, and get back towards the hydraulic tank. So that's how a main relief valve protects the hydraulic pump. See, the main relief valve.
Relief valve とか, one direction valve とか, there's a set, yes? It's only that. This is a kind of, this is one, piston cylinder, linear motion. And in some cases, it works in the rotational actuator. こうやってですね、ローテーションアクチュエーターがこうやってやって、なんか、プレッシャーがあって、It makes a rotating disc. なんか、そのローテーションコンディションに、ローテーションパーツに、It is used.Because this kind of construction machine is produce many high power. It needs high power. So because of the high power output is necessary. So in this case, in this kind of case, the power source is mainly the oil pressure. Okay, oil pressure is used mainly as a linear movement, piston cylinder movement.But in some cases, the rotary actuator is necessary. Also the rotary actuator driven by oil pressure is necessary, is required. So therefore, this kind of product is there in the market. Rotary actuator, but it works in the air, not only air, but oil pressure. So the significant large amount of output, rotary, linear, and the response is good because, yes, what is the difference? Oil pressure actuator and the pneumatic actuator, what is the main difference? Oil actuator to air actuator, what is the main difference?
The power, the hydraulic power, is come from like electric to push the oil, make high pressure. But the second is use the heat, I think.
Second use for the heat.
The pneumatic use the
pneumatic what?
Yeah. It's used old tree.
Like air pump.
Yes, it's okay.
Yes, your idea. What is the main difference of pneumatic actuator and the hydraulic actuator?
Maybe the main difference is. Why is oil, why is air?
Yes. Oh, so based on that, what is the difference? What kind of?
Yeah, based on the material. So the reaction frequency response is different.
Yes, but why the frequency response is different? Why frequency response is different? Yes, response, good, but it's worse. Response quickly, not difficult to response quickly in general. Why? Pneumatic actuator.
Compressive.
It accumulation. Yes, but the oil cannot compress. But air easily compresses its volume. So the response is not good. But lightweight is the, and also the saturated, so fluid, working fluid is, yes, very, we can get air in anywhere, so easy to use, but to the, it is compressed easily, accumulated easily, so the quick response is difficult for you by using the pneumatic actuator. Okay? This is the main thing. And also, this is a general characteristic. This is a frequency response, and this is a power. So high power is used in the hydraulic, and the low power is used in electric motor. And but the frequency, the solenoid is used, and the pneumatic actuator, the power is here, but the frequency is not good. It's a pneumatic actuator. Solenoid is a. Solenoid って何ですかって like a coil to one on-off coil. What's that? Coil, yeah? You don't know? Solenoid. Yes, only coil. Coil, ne?
Most common type of solenoid acts as a linear actuator.
Here, linear actuator, on.
When electric current is applied.
Solenoid.
A solenoid only returns to its extended state in spring or
so. Spring back no solenoid to cut. Yes, how it makes it looks like the nanka for the high for the nanka.
Solenoid
can
launch.
Coil ni nanka. On ni suru to, yes. Some magnetic field to dekite, yes, this armature is pushed. Feel that, yes, it's okay. And the next is DC motor and AC motor. Yes, and the stepping motor. Yes, in many miniature motor is used also on a vehicle. Vehicle is automobile. has not only the engine, but also many kinds of motor, electric motor is used. For example, the door mirror or some door lock or air conditioning, power window or something. There are many kinds of small motor, miniature motor is used in the vehicle. Yes, and also the FDD. What is FDD? What is FDD? もうみんな知らない。え、フロッピーディスクドライバー知らないですか？フロッピーディスクドライバー。フロッピーディスクドライバーこうですね。知らないよね、もうね。あれ、パワーポイント動作を停止しました。どうしてでしょう？はい。これ何？こっちで見る。FDD、フロッピーディスクドライバーですよ。ちょっと待って、こんなことやってる暇はない。どこ行った？どこだ？これで、こうかね。あ、こういうやつがあったね。フロッピーディスクっていう、このワンディスクドライブで、ここが、この前言った、ボールスクリューで、ボールスクリューで、トラッキングサムヘッド。And the reading and writing, the data is a floppy disk drive. Floppy disk drive because this disk is very flexible material, made of flexible material, and four side and back side it can write and read. Yes, okay. And also the hard disk drive is here. Hard disk drive is here. So the hard disk drive.Some motor is used, also the spindle motor and also the voice coil motor. Voice coil motor is the two types of voice coil motor is used. The coil is here, so this is a permanent magnet. Permanent magnet makes some field, and this coil is also makes some field, so it can move, the linear movement.And also in this case, this is a coil is here, this is a linear movement, so this is a permanent coil, so it moves like this. This is a voice coil motor. Yes, voice coil motor is move this arm to head location, head positioning. Okay? And this is a printer. Printer has also some many kinds of motors.Yes, this is a inkjet printer. Inkjet printer is... あ、これもまたなんかバカになってますね。Yes, ダメですね。ちょっとなんか、ダメだから。やめましょう。じゃあ、これはちょっと見て、こう。わかりました。このビデオはここでは Windows 8では見にくいってことですね。Yes. これやめて、skip here. Yes, the plain paper copy.Plain paper copy, some drum or head are here, so the toner is provided here, and the paper is paper handling. So the source sheet is put on this table, and this scanner is scanning this character or some drawing or something, and then the paper is from here to here. And in some cases,The both copying, so it is feeded once here and feeded again to reverse to make it to make the page reversely, and the back side is also copied, and also the source sheet is stored here, and it is provided one and here, and but in some cases it is also.Read both sides, not only front side but also back side. So it is stored here and put on here to read and to make it the reverse read. This reverse unit is used to make the seat reverse and stored it again. Yes. So the motor in copier, the scanning and all manuscript reading is sometimes using the brushless motor, DC sub motor, PLL control, pulse constant phase lock loop control for high precision reading. But in some cases, for the cheaper machine, the stepping motor, open loop stepping motor, is used. And the scanning on the open writing is the most important part. Scanning for writing is the most important part. So laser scan and laser writing is the most important part. So the scanner motor is like the brushless motor in PLL control. It moves like more than 5,000 or 10,000 rotation per minute. Rotary unevenness is smaller than 0.01%. So the rotary unevenness is very, very smooth, and the even rotation is necessary for the scanning. This makes the quality of this copy. Therefore, this is the most important part. So, and also paper feeding, toner feeding, ventilation fan is not so important. Only the low price DC motor is used. So in this case, one machine, there are several motors is used. And you can understand which part is the main part, which part is basically the main part, and it needs high precision, high power or something. And the business high quality model, you should use high performance motor, but to home usage or low cost product, you should use more low cost motor. Okay? So it needs the right item in right place. Performance, cost, effect, and so on. You should put right. Yes, this is all of them are DC motor, but you should select each portion, the appropriate motor. Okay, this is one message here. The DC motor, maybe you know the Fleming's left hand law. Yes, electric field and magnetic field and current. Okay, maybe you can understand. And also coil wiring, so this is the basic of the DC motor. And I have shown firstly here. And yes, maybe you know DC motor, AC motor. Yes, DC's most important feature is torque. Current, torque is rotation speed. And the current is almost linear, so it is easy to control. But alternative current motor, AC motor, it has some non-linearity, low efficiency, so it is a little bit difficult to control. But presently, some sub-unit is attached on each motor, so it's not so difficult to control. But for the robot usage, yes, AC motor is mainly used for the constant rotation, maybe. Constant rotation, kanaka. Yes, but the robot, not so much movement, not so large movement area, because elbow, it cannot move more than half rotation. Only limited angle it must drive. So the not so large amount of rotation is not necessary, and also high speed rotation is not so necessary. So the DC motor is more controllable, more easy to control for the joint in robot. For example, you may know the Ashimo. A humanoid robot by Honda Corporation. Honda developed the DC motor especially for the Ashimo's robot. For example, the DC motor. But DC motor is also, yes, later I will explain later because the time limited. Yes, DC motor's basic characteristics like this. This is the torque and the speed, and this is the currency. Yes, speed, torque speed ratio, torque speed line is here, and the torque current line is here. So the yes, it looks like this. And the unloaded speed is here, speed maximum. And rated speed is here. Rated speed, rated torque is a basic characteristic of the DC motor. And the maximum torque is makes when the speed is zero. Okay? And time constant, I have to explain two time constants. One is a mechanical time constant, and the next page is electrical time constant. This is, when the stationary current is flowing here, yes, this is a motor, this is a source, this is a power source, voltage source, and RA is the coil's resistance of the coil. So Ohm's law is here. So the VO is supplying, and E is applied voltage to the motor. IR, this is the resistance, and the currency is here. So this is a static condition, okay? The E is the voltage is applied to the motor is a counter electromotive force. It is depending on the speed, omega t. Omega t is the speed, ke is the ratio. And the rotor torque, generation torque is depending on the, related to the currency, kt is the ratio. Okay? Ke, kt is the ratio. So inertia is Jm, rotor's inertia is Jm, motor inertia is Jm, torque is here. So the omega dt, j omega d, j no, j is the inertia, yes. You have to review this equations later for your subject this week. So at this time, at that time, I ask you to add. Yes. V equal なんだっけ E プラス IR って書いてあるね。This is the equation. Ohm's law. Simple Ohm's law. Yes. Volt. Volt is V. Yes. Okay. And motors. Yes. Is okay. The current is ampere. R is ohm. Yes. You should write each equation on this unit. Yes, I will ask, add the unit on each of them, okay, later. Okay, for example, inertia, Jm, dt, d omega, equal torque でしょ? Torque はニュートンメーターで、これはオメガはラディアンパーセカンドで、で、タイムで割るからまたタイムで割って、で、イナーシャは何すか?イナーシャは何すか?キログラムメーター2乗ですね。メータースクエアですね。Maybe. You have to add. Yes. Yes. This is the same as the Newton meter. You have to check. Okay. This kind of thing you have to do later. Okay.This is this line, and tau m is called mechanical time constant. Yes, time constant. It says. It says tau m. もう書けないな別な。
How m イコールなんだ J の R の KT の KE って書いてあるよね KE って Yes it calls time constant time constant ね time constant means this unit what is this unit second で time なんだから time second でも J はさっき言ったイナーシ R は O KT はなんかわかんない KE もなんかそこに書いてある Yes so you should check this could be the time okay you have to check laterYes, these equations is input on this Ohm's law equation. This makes the first order lab system. Looks like this. Can you see the input is the voltage, output is the speed of rotation? Okay, rotation speed. This equation shows the first order lab system.And then it, yes, this is the time order system, time unit system, time based system. From this to this, Laplace transformation. You know Laplace transformation? All of the students know the Laplace transformation. So the time based to the S based system, S based equation.Yes, only the, yes, this is S, yes, dt, ddt, ddt makes only S is added here. And this is a transfer function, input is voltage, output is the speed of rotation, so that it shows like this. Okay? Omega, and the, in this case,step response. What is step response? What is step response? 知ってます? Step response って。What is step response? ファンさん、What is step response? 知ってる?
I didn't know the meaning of English.
Step
order,
V 分のオメガって書いてあるけど。Yes, this is a function, transfer function. V is voltage is input, omega is output. Yes, and step response is, yes, this is V. V changes from, yes, this is time, time zero.The voltage is a stepped input.
Yes.
And the, how about the response of omega? Omega is a step response. This is input. Input is voltage. Output is omega. So the, how the, this output, speed of rotation moves. Well, sometimes it looks like this.Sometimes it looks like this. Okay, this is step response. Step input, then how about the output? It's a step response. You should understand, okay? Yes, step response is only the S 分の V かけるの。So, S 分の V で、yes. Step response is S 分の V.Yes, in this case, this is S domain equation. Then this is S from S domain to the time domain. It is transferred like this. This is the time domain. So the omega's response is like this. So the here is the mechanical time constant. Okay, here.And the electrical time constant is almost the same. This is, in this case, transient current. In this case, current is the input. Current is output. Then the voltage is applied. Yes, this LA is a coil effect. Coil effect. So Ohm's law is looks like this. The yes. When the nani this current is changed, the coil effect is occurred. Become nani clear. Make some effect. Coil effect. It looks like this. LA is this. なんて言うんだっけ?
ん? はい。
このコイルのコンスタントは何て言う
の? コイルのコンスタント?
ディンカ。
ホ
ゾスビリングね。
コイルエフェクトだよね。 はい。 コイルエフェクトパラメーターのコンスタントだよね。 Yes. OK? So this equation is looks like this. So in this case, the input is a voltage, output is this current. So the effect is the voltage is input. How to change the current? Currency is this condition. When you apply some voltage input, what is the current change? Okay. So the time constant is in this case electric time constant, LA per RA is a time constant. You should check that this is also the time unit, okay? And this is the first law application, Laplace equation, and so on. The step response looks like this. So that this is also almost the same as the previous page. So this is some cases. The step response of DC motor voltage input in single step in form is like this. Voltage is changed like this. And the current response is like this. So the current is here. Current is here. Electric time constant, for example, the 1.1 millisecond. And the angular velocity response, the rotational speed response looks like this, okay? So it shows, in some cases, in the specification table, it shows 14 millisecond. And this time, time E, TE, tau E, 1.1 second, it shows that this is the final value of the current. This is the final value, final speed of rotation. And in time T tau M, it is 63.2%. It also 63.2%. Why it is? 例えば 1.1 millisecond is here. It shows the 63% of the final value. Time tau t, tau m, 14 millisecond. It shows 63% of the final value. It's a speed of rotation. Why it is also including in this today's subject. Okay? And skip here, and servo motor is skipped here. And servo motor is only the input signal, when the input signal looks like this, the step response. Ideal motor's speed of movement looks like this, but commonly it moves. Slowly stopped. But servo motor is more quick response, with sharp response. Yes, this is a servo motor, only that. Not the exact difference from common motor and servo motor. Relatively quickly response. Yes, it looks like this, the characteristic is like this, and this is an example of the specification table. Yes, rated power, rated armature voltage, rated torque, rated armature currents, rated speeds. And also you can see, yes, armature coil resistance is also shown
rotation, that the rotor inertia is shown in the table. Torque constant. Rotated rated power ratio とか and also mechanical time constant, electrical time constant is shown in the specification table of each commercially available DC servo motor. Okay? Weight is also added here. Yes, and also the another 5 minutes, remaining 5 minutes, explain about the control of the DC servo motor.Skip here. And the PWM control only pulse width modulation. Pulse width modulation, you can understand the duty ratio, changing the duty ratio, it makes the average speed. Duty ratio become higher, more higher speed. And the duty ratio become lower, the lower speed. Okay? Only the pulse width modulation control method. Okay?And the next part is a PID control. PID control. Proportional. P is a proportional. Yes. This is a how to calculate the command to the input of the sub amplifier. Yes. Only P element or integral element.And the derivative element. So the only P is common to servo amp is in proportional to deviation signal. But yes, if you add the integral element, the residual error becomes zero. And the derivative element, you should add the derivative element.Response is improved. Okay? Yes, this is a commonly known. It is a, maybe the, this is a basic of the, if you run the control engineering, this is a basic thing. Okay? Maybe you can find some explanations in any places. And this is another aspect.This is a motor current is feedback in the servo amp. Motor speed is feedback. Compensation circuit. And the position is also feedback. Yes, torque current feedback is sometimes a torque feedback. It means that current and torque, motor current and motor torque is related, linear relationship.So the current feedback means similar to the torque feedback, and the speed feedback, and the position feedback, okay? And yes, this is the total of the system. This is motor is here, and this is the amplifier to drive the motor.Current feedback. Speed sensor is here, speed feedback. Compared with position feedback. Position feedback. Position command is input. Yes, this is a position control system. Motor position control system. Yes. This wrist, yes, this elbow is moved to the.45 degree, 19 degree, 0 degree. This looks like this, okay? So the current feedback, speed feedback, position feedback. Current feedback improves the system's stability and response. And speed feedback makes the, yes,makes the viscosity efficient, settles the viscosity efficient. So the speed feedback, you can change, if you change the feedback gain, speed feedback gain, you can change the system's viscosity. Okay? And the position feedback, if you, gain ってわかります?
gain. Gain. え、ゲイ、なんかさ、フィードバックシステムの、まあいや、なんかこうやってモーターがあって、例えばポジションをセンシングしてフィードバックしますよね。なんかポジションのターゲットポジション、ターゲットポジションね。で、ポジションセンサーがあるから、ポジションセンサーでポジションのプレゼントポジションが分かりますね。で、プラスマイナスで、これがエラーですね。ポジションエラーですね。デルタ P とかなんか、ポジションエラーですね。ポジションエラーがビカムゼロになるように、これフィードバックコントロール。フィードバックコントロール means the position error, position error become zero。で、ここになんかさ、K とかさ、K とかなんか、K って表す、KP とか、あ、P、KP って言うと、G、G か。GP とかですよ。ゲイン、P。例えばなんかゲイン、ポジションゲイン。ね。で、ポジションゲインでなんかモーターのシステムなんか、モーターはセカンドオーダーシステムとかになんか、セカンドオーダーシステムになんか、Yes、モデル。セカンドオーダーシステムモデルするとしてだよ。で、なんかこれでフィードバックして、Yes、you should、You should think the なんかインプットアウトプットのなんかインプットアウトプットのなんかこの計算しましょうという this system です。で、ポジションフィードバックゲインで、ポジションフィードバックゲインを if you change the position feedback gain this system is this system is elasticity can be changed and also.The speed, yes, some speed detector, some speed sensor is here, the speed feedback is here, and the speed gain, GS, speed gain, is here. So if you change this parameter, you can change this system's elasticity, じゃなくて、これは viscosity.で、so if you write the block diagram of this system directly, and this is some, you should set some position controllers gain, speed controllers gain. You can find this gain makes this system's viscosity or elasticity. だ普通のそういうのだからさ、なんだっけ、よくあるトルクよくあるじゃん、なんだっけ、トルク is イナーシャのオメガドットとプラス、え、ちょっと待ってよ、やだな、あ、いいや、これじゃなくていいや、 F イコール M アルファドットプラス MV ドットと BV と K これだだよね。で、これが This is a inertia で、これが viscosity で、あ、違う、これが elasticity だよね。 viscosity、elasticity、 え、わかります？だから ここに Yes, maybe this GP is affected to this parameter, this condition. GS makes this parameter in here. Okay, directly you can check like this. If you write the block diagram and set some gain in here.So that it makes it maybe you can find some second order equation maybe, and you can find this parameter contains this gain and this parameter contains this gain maybe. もう5分経ってますね。すいませんね。というわけで、
you should refer, for example, this kind of you should access and read that. Mainly, but it's only in Japanese. I cannot understand. I cannot remember about that. But yes, maybe it's a similar thing. Yes, this is written in your material handout. Okay.